When Rasulullah was 35 years old, that was the time when the Quraysh had the need to rebuild the Kaaba. That was because the Kaaba was then a low building. It was not as high as it is today. It was a low building of white stones with no more than the length of 9 arms, height of 9 arms. And it was as such from the time of Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam. And this was the first time the Kaaba was going to be rebuilt after that time. And also, it was also a roofless structure. When Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam built it, it was roofless. It did not have a roof. So this also left the Kaaba open to theft, because Kaaba did contain treasures inside. And of course, Kaaba was built centuries ago, so there were natural elements which made it necessary for the rebuilding of Kaaba as well, such as the 35th year of the year of the elephants. That was when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was 35 years old, and it was 5 years before the mission of the prophethood began. There came a flood in Mecca, and this flood almost demolished the Kaaba. This flood highly weakened the walls and brought cracks in it, which led to the need of rebuilding of the walls. So the chiefs of the Quraysh decided to use only licit money in rebuilding Kaaba. So all money derived from immoral means, usury and unjust practice was excluded. Now a point here, even the likes of Abu Jahl knew that usury is haram, usury is wrong, usury is unjust. Even the likes of the leaders of the Quraysh who did not accept Islam till the end, who died in the Battle of Badr, they too knew and accepted that usury, riba, is haram, is injustice to the poor. Now the Quraysh, at first, they were too fearful to knock down the wall, because if they have to rebuild the wall, then they have to first bring the wall down. It hasn't been happened since the time of Ismail alayhi salatu wasalam, since the time it has been built. So just imagine. But then Al-Walid ibn al-Mughira was the first one to do this task, and he was from Banu Makhzum. Now the Quraysh saw that no harm came to Al-Walid. Now this Al-Walid is the father of Khalid ibn Walid. You understand this, right? So looking that no harm came to Al-Walid ibn al-Mughira, so the other Quraysh too marched forth and joined Al-Walid. Now continuing this process of removing the stones of the Kaaba, they reached the foundation of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, which was built by Ibrahim himself. And from there, right from where they reached the foundation of Ibrahim, they started rebuilding its walls. And they divided the work among different tribes of Quraysh. Each tribe was responsible for rebuilding a part of it. And the man who laid the stones of Kaaba, he was a Roman mason from Rome. He was called Baqum, a man named Baqum. So the work went on in harmony and no problem was being faced until the time came to put the sacred black stone in its proper place. Now keeping the black stone of the Kaaba is a huge honor, and whichever tribe does that, he is going to be honored always in future. Everyone is going to say, this is the tribe who had laid the black stones of the Kaaba. That tribe will automatically get a boost in honor and respect. So a strife broke out among the chiefs of Makkah, and it lasted for 4 or 5 days, and each tribe was contesting over the honor of placing the black stone in the right position. And it said that even daggers were on the point of being drawn and great bloodshed seemed imminent. It was obvious that now the tribes are going to fight with each other. But ultimately, the oldest among the chiefs of Makkah, the oldest, according to one opinion, he was Abu Umayyah bin Mughira al-Makhzumi. And according to another opinion, he is Mu'tim ibn Adi. So whosoever he is, he made a proposal that was accepted by all. And the proposal was that let him who enters the sanctuary first decide on the point. Whoever enters this area of Haram first, let him decide that what is the solution. So it was assumed that whichever tribe will come first, that person will say that my tribe will put the black stone. And this was obviously understood. But the one to enter first, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was 35 years old Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as soon as Rasulullah came in, everyone among the Quraysh shouted out together that Al-Amin has come, the trustworthy has come, whatever he says, we are ready to obey. So in future, until the declaration of prophethood, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was praised for being an arbitrator between the leaders of Quraysh, which stopped a situation of fitna which could lead to bloodshed. Now what did Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam say? Did he say that Banu Hashim will do this? He rather offered a solution. He asked for a piece of cloth to be spread and the black stone to be kept over it. And then all of the leaders of the Quraysh can hold on to that piece of cloth and they can pick up the black stone together and go to Al-Kaaba. And then they will raise up the cloth until the height which is required to be and bring it in position where it has to be kept. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself will lay the stone in the proper position with his own hands. And this is how a very tense situation was eased and everyone agreed to what Rasulullah said. That yes, all the tribes are getting the honor together and Muhammad, the praiseworthy who is respected by all and who is the grandson of Abdul Muttalib. Actually, we should say the grandson of the favorite son of Abdul Muttalib. Abdullah was the favorite son of Abdul Muttalib and Muhammad was the only son of Abdullah. Then the Quraysh ran out of licit money they collected. So they eliminated an area which was something covering 6 arms length on the northern side of Al-Kaaba, which is called as Al-Hatin. And another thing that they did was they raised the door from ground level. Previously the door was at the ground level and there were 2 doors. People could enter from one side and exit from other side. Now there was 1 door and that door was at a height so that anybody cannot enter just by desire, because now people, the Quraysh, wanted to protect their treasures inside. Now when they are designing the structure, they are designing according to their needs and they want to protect the treasures inside. So no 2 doors, only 1 door, and the door is not at a height through which everyone can enter. So finally, when the building was completed, and yes, also the roof was supported by 6 columns. So a roof was made for the first time and it rested on 6 columns, 6 pillars. So finally, when Kaaba was finished, then it was approximately a square form, about 15 meters high, and 2 opposing sides were 10 meters and the other 2 opposing sides were 12 meters. So the structure was 10 into 12 into 15. And black stone was 1.5 meters from the ground level. This is how the new structure, the new building or the rebuilding of the Kaaba was done. Now finally, there's also a symbolism hidden in the rebuilding of the Kaaba. And the symbolism is very obvious. Right at the birth of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, a Christian king, Abraha, attacked the Kaaba. But Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala protected it. Right? And that was the year of the birth of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And in it is the symbolism that Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala has not forgotten Al-Kaaba. Even though Baytul Maqdis is now the Qibla, Baytul Maqdis is now the Holy Land, but it does not mean that Kaaba is not a Haram. And Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is protecting the Kaaba. And in the year of the birth of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala protected the Kaaba through his miracle. Now, just 5 years before Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam declared his prophethood, and Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala sent Jibreel with the Quran to Rasulullah, Allah first sent a flood and actually broke the structure, the standing structure, Al-Kaaba, depicting that Kaaba had these idols in it and had these impurities in it now, and it needs to be cleansed. And Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala sends flood, water which cleanses the land, and actually the Kaaba is broken. And then the rebuilding of the Kaaba by the hands of the Quraysh, and Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam placing the black stone on it, depicting the future of a very close time, how Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is going to cleanse Al-Kaaba and bring it back to the original monotheistic state.